sitting here wondering, bad spot for my clothes.
Well, I'm Chris Riccardo. I am the sculpture department and foundry director at the Armory Art Center. I've been here at the Armory for almost 15 years. I've been in the area for probably 25 years and have lived in Jupiter the whole time. I'd like to think that I'm an artist first and, you know, a good father, you know, a good husband, but, you know, it's art is really who I am. So I'd have to say, I hope that I'm considered an artist and first and foremost, and that's what people know me as. And a guy with a pretty good mustache too, so. Well, I went to the College of Fine Arts at Boston University, and it was very heavy on the figure, and that's what we did. And, you know, really that's what I've always known and what I've loved to do. So I just don't see myself doing anything other than that. And I think for me, it's always just this challenge of, you know, representing the figure well in the way I think it should be done. And so really it's what I love, you know, as far as figurative work. I think I find sculpture to be easier of all of that, you know, but there's definitely challenges, you know, in that. And I have a hard time, you know, I still think I'm still struggling to make a decent head and, you know, something that looks to me right and, you know, the way a figure should look. So yeah, I think without question that Alberto Giacometti was my biggest influence, and just his work and as far as my style and his, I think it's very similar. And you know, I think his thought process and what influenced him, you know, always interested me, and I see a lot of similarities, I think, in him and I. And so I think that's as far as my inspiration. I mean, beyond that, I think, you know, I would have to say probably my family would be probably my other inspiration to keep me going. And, you know, without them, I wouldn't, you know, because it's not an easy life doing what we do. And, you know, my kids understand it and my wife gets it. And, you know, so without them, it would be impossible. So I think they're a huge inspiration on me. But I'll usually come up with an idea and it'll probably change so much from that initial, you know, first thought that I had or image in my head. So it's just this constant ongoing changing thing, you know, in my work. But now I have a much more specific direction that I'm gonna go in, and it's more about me. So it's gonna be more about, you know, I think what I felt has either helped me or hurt me in my life. And so, you know, this whole next series is gonna be all about that. And I think, you know, I've always felt that whole thing about, you know, well, you should either write about or sculpt what you know. And, you know, and I think, I don't think I've done enough of that. And so I, you know, this, it's a challenge for me, and I think it's also a good thing. And I think it'll be kind of a process of getting a lot of this stuff out, which I have no problem doing, you know, but, and at the same time, I can still do my work and keep it pretty dark, but at the same time have some, you know, kind of fun with it, and hopefully people will get it and understand it. Can we be private? Probably not, because I think that's part of the whole sell. You know, it's not just, unfortunately, it's not just, you know, here's my painting, here's my sculpture. You know, it's like you were saying before, it's, you know, what's the story behind this? You know, what's the story with you? You know, I think they want more. You know, it's a whole package, and, you know, I guess we have to be more like, you know, a brand, you know, and marketed, and that's unfortunate. I don't like that part of it, but I think you have to do that to play this game, you know, and that's fine, you know, and I get it, and I do have times where I'm just, you know, this is it, take it or leave it, and, you know, but I get the game now, and unfortunately, I think young kids coming up are probably understanding that better than I did, or I was taught, you know. For me, it was just, this is the art, do it, be quiet. It's, you know, as far as the sexuality stuff, that's always been a part of my work. I don't know. I think it's just, maybe it's been a good or a bad thing. I don't know, as far as in my life and just that whole pursuit of it in my own life, and has it, you know, hurt me? You know, I spent too much time chasing after that and not enough time, you know, in my life and my work and stuff. So I think that's probably a big reason why it's in my work a lot. And, you know, are there some deep, weird things? You know, I don't know. I don't think so. You know, as far as growing up as a kid, I think it was pretty normal, but probably just spending too much of my time thinking about that and chasing it around. But it's something that comes natural in my work, and, you know, I don't set out to shock, because I don't see what I do as shocking. You know, to me, it just isn't at all. And you know, it probably is to a lot of people. But to me, it's just what I do, you know. If I do it, it's because I like the idea. As I'm progressing through it, you know, I start to like the image, or, you know, or the piece itself, and that's it, you know. And if I'm pissing people off, you know, get over it. It's really not, you know, it's not upsetting to me in any way. And I really don't think I've done anything to this point that's, you know, so upsetting that it's gonna, you know, affect somebody for the rest of their lives. But, you know, and it's tough being an artist. It's tough doing work like that, because you limit yourself. You know, it's not easy to show what people consider to be erotic, or, you know, or just using that word puts you in a whole nother category. And it's tough, you know. So I think I try and work it in a way where it's, you know, it's there, but maybe not so much where it's going to keep me out of a certain situation. But, you know, either way, I'll find a way to show it. Or any reaction to me is a good reaction, because you're looking, you know. And if it's more bad, fine, so what? You've seen it, you know, and it's made an effect on you, and you won't forget it, for sure. So, I mean, that's really what, you know, what drives me and who I am. It's not, it just comes out, you know? Don't do it. Find another career. Number one, I think you have to, you know, it's got to be what, you know, not what you want to do, but it's what you have to do. You know, I mean, I think you have to feel every morning when you get up that you need to create something. It's just, you know, if it's not a part of you, then don't, you know, get into this and struggle. And, you know what I mean, it's either in you or it isn't. And I think, you know, you better have some tough skin, and you better be able to take criticism and use that, you know, and learn from it. If you can't, get out now. It's tough. I mean, it's a tough business. It really is. But I wouldn't trade it for anything. So I leave in about a week to go to the Archie Bray Foundation in Helena, Montana. And that is a group that was formed to basically help further the career of ceramic artists. And they give us the opportunity to have a studio space and just do nothing but work for an extended period of time. So it's just a group of like-minded people that are there, and kind of feeding off each other and just working and showing and, you know, talking about what we do. So it's exciting, and I cannot wait to get there and have no distractions for 3 months and hopefully get a lot of work done. So that's where I'm going. And then hopefully having a show in October coming up back here in South Florida. So that's the immediate, and we'll see what happens from there.
Well, let me be your little dog till your big dog come. Let me be your little dog till your big dog come. When the big dog gets here, show him what this little puppy done. Well, I say, hey, woman, man, hold my clothes. Yeah, I say, little woman, with a matchbox, hold my clothes. I ain't got no matches, got a long way to go. Let her go, boy, go, go. Baby, I'm sitting here wondering with a matchbox on my clothes. I ain't got no